Starting the first bank in South Dakota was the easy part, earning the confidence of local farmers, helping families account for their dreams, and securing the future for countless businesses took us a little longer. We owe it to the hard workers, big dreamers, and forward thinkers out there. Thank you for making South Dakota a great place to call home.
Hello and welcome to Sertoma Park in Yankton, South Dakota, as a midday softball game between the Yankton Gazelles and the Spearfish Spartans set to take place. We're just about 30 minutes out. Noon is game time, and it's a beautiful day. It really is. There's not really much wind. The sun is shining. It's not too hot. I've got my work T-shirt and shorts, so you couldn't ask for a nicer day and a better work day, as instead of the office, I'm outside enjoying this beautiful weather, preparing for some softball against between the Yankton Gazelles and the Spearfish Spartans. Both teams come into this matchup at 1-3 apiece, as we'll take a look at how both of the teams came to their current record and what's upcoming for each team. So we'll start with the traveling team, the Spearfish Spartans. They started their season at home. They took on Sturgis Brown in a close one. They lost 6-13. They then took on Aberdeen Central at home. So they started their season with three straight home games. Against Aberdeen Central, they won big time. 17-2 was the final score in that one. They then took on Watertown, a very good Watertown team who's 5-1 currently on the season. Watertown defeated Spearfish 18-2. And in their final game, Spearfish took on O'Gorman in O'Gorman yesterday, in which they lost 3-21. Now, makes it a little better when you have a two-day trip. You're able to spend the night and kind of somewhat recuperate before your next game. As I did make sure to ask Coach Lubkins, she said they were able to stay here in town, so they didn't have to make the drive from Spearfish to Sioux Falls back, then come to Yankton, drive back. And so, of course, the game at noon today. Their next couple games are all at home. Rapid City Stevens on the 16th, Brandon Valley on the 19th, Harrisburg on the 20th. On the 26th, Sioux Falls, Washington, and their final game of the month is against Sioux Falls, Roosevelt. So that's just kind of a quick look ahead at some of their upcoming stuff. For the Yankton Gazelles, they also come in at 1-3, and they won their last time they were on the field. As their first game, they traveled to Brandon Valley, a very close game. They lost by 3 runs. It was 7-4. Then at home against a very good Harrisburg team. Harrisburg currently undefeated, 3-0 on the season. They lost 18-1. They then had a home stand against Sioux Falls Roosevelt, and it says 8-0. I could have swore it was 9-0. Maybe my numbers were off, but 8-0 they lost, and now Rapid City Central was last night, in which they came out on top in a big win for the Gazelles, 18-3. So they're hoping to bring some of that momentum of their last victory into this game. They have a doubleheader. They take on Spearfish today at noon. Pier TF Riggs is at 4. Then upcoming, they travel to T Area. That's next Monday. We will actually be at that game. And then when they travel to Sturgis Brown, Rapid City Stevens, we won't be able to make those games to stream. But then right back at home against Watertown. And then they, again, on the road, a far one, Aberdeen Central. And to wrap up their month, they have a homestand against Vermilion. Now, of course, I usually call the Yankton games. Michael Schumacher usually calls the Tanager games. We'll keep you up to date on who's calling it and what streaming service or which channel you'll be able to watch on. You'll have to stay tuned to both Classic Hits 106.3 and ESPN Radio 1570 AM 101.5 FM. Again, I did get a chance to talk with both of the head coaches ahead of this matchup. We'll be right back to hear what both thought about the game and even more on our Yankton Medical Clinic pregame show in a moment on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Seasons Power Sports in Yankton can help make your life easier and more fun. All Seasons Power Sports can help you with ATVs, side-by-sides, fishing and pleasure boats, as well as motorcycles, watercraft, and more. Check out their inventory at allseasonspowersportsinc.com. All Seasons Power Sports, your authorized Honda and Yamaha dealer on your way to the lake in Yankton.
At Avera, we believe good health starts early, and that good health care can inspire a life of wellness. At Avera, we believe in push-ups and pumping iron, we believe less is more. And live for apple slices instead of apple pie. At Avera, we live for staying healthy and enjoying the little things. We're invested in healthy living so you can live longer.
At Elwood Family Dental Care, we treat our patients like family. We have an experienced and caring dental team. We take the time to make sure you understand your oral health and answer any questions you have about your dental treatments. We take pride in educating our patients. Whether you need fillings, crowns or bridges, dental implants, just a teeth cleaning, or even Botox, come visit us at 1818 Broadway Avenue. And remember, we take care of the entire family.
Being the first bank in South Dakota was the easy part. Earning the confidence of local farmers, helping families account for their dreams, and securing the future for countless businesses took us a little longer. We owe it to the hard workers, big dreamers, and forward thinkers out there. Thank you for making South Dakota a great place to call home.
To our coaches' conversations, I'm Zach Spear, and on the other end of the line with me is head coach Belle Lubkin of the Spearfish Spartans. Coach, how are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing well. Looking forward to a lot of softball here to cover. Could you tell me what your season has looked like so far?
It's been interesting to learn my girls. This is our first year running a varsity program, and it's my first year as a head coach, so it's just been about getting to know my girls, getting to kind of get a flow to things. I think my varsity girls, they're really starting to gel. They're starting to become a family. So that's been our kind of goal to start the season. And I think as we started to do that, we've gotten a little bit more united on the field as well. So
what are some of the things that your team does well?
I think they keep a positive energy. We're a pretty loud team. We bring a lot of energy. And you can see that on the field and in the dugout. Another thing is we started to get our bats going. We've had a couple girls that have been huge, huge spots for us in the lineup. Kiana Salaker, she had a great game against Aberdeen Central last week. We have a couple other girls who are really starting to find their way. Danica Brown, she's scored a decent amount of runs for us. So it's been exciting to kind of see these girls and see what they can do because I haven't coached them before this year.
And so now you have back-to-back game days, and they're quite some distance from Spearfish. I'm hoping you don't have to make the drive in back-to-back days, right?
No, we're coming down. We'll play O'Gorman tomorrow, Thursday, and then we drive down to Yankton and play Yankton on Friday. So we'll drive back-to-back days, but we'll spend the night in Yankton before.
Well, good to hear, because speaking of that drive, it is quite a long one. What are some of the positives and negatives of having such a long trip for you and your team?
I think the negatives is just kind of sitting on the bus all day and then getting ready to play. It'll also be a pretty quick turnaround playing Thursday and then waking up Friday to getting ready to go. But I think that some of the positives is these girls get to spend a lot of time together. We have a pretty young team. We have a lot of middle school, a couple middle schoolers on our varsity. So I think it's a new experience for them to kind of travel with the team and get that experience. I think some other positives is just going out to the other side of the state and seeing a little bit more competition over there too.
And so you mentioned having a pretty young team. How many seniors do you have then on your team?
We just have one senior on our team.
Wow. So it has. Have you seen her being kind of a leader as the oldest one out there? How has that worked for you?
I think Kiana is definitely a silent leader. She's not a super loud and outgoing girl, but she definitely, her bat is loud, I will say, in our lineup. She is our four hitter. She drives home a lot of runs. She makes a huge impact on this team. So it's great to have a senior who can do that out on the field.
And so coming up here, you take on the Gazelles. It's going to be a midday matchup. What are you hoping to see your team do well in this one?
I think our goal right now is to really keep our bats consistent. We've had a couple games where we just couldn't string hits together. So I think our goal going out East River is just to be able to get some swings going, make contact consistently, and make our lineup work a little bit more, make pitchers work a little bit more. I think that's my main goal for the team this weekend.
And so now you've mentioned a few names throughout this interview. Who are some of the players on your team that are routinely making big plays, can be either in the field or at the plate as well?
Yeah, I would say Kiana Stalker. She's probably our biggest bat out in the field and on the bases. Liv Johnson and Emmy Johnson, they're both eighth graders. They're twins, but they're really fun to watch on the bases. They both have pretty consistent bats and also make an impact out in our field. Liv Johnson's our catcher. She's just a super fun kid to watch. She's a baller. She goes all out on everything. We have a few girls who just have really stepped up to the plate this year with a first-year program and have kind of led the way, some young girls too.
Well, Coach, thank you so much for taking time out of your schedule to sit down and talk with me. I look forward to the game, and good luck.
Thank you so much. It was nice talking to you.
Again, that was Belle Lubkin, head coach of the Spearfish Spartans, on our Coach's Conversations. We'll be back with more of our Yankton Medical Clinic pregame show in a moment on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube. To our Coach's Conversations, I'm Zach Spear, and on the other end of the line with me is head coach Belle Lubkin of the Spearfish Spartans. Coach, how are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing well. Looking forward to a lot of softball here to cover. Could you tell me what your season has looked like so far?
It's been interesting to learn my girls. This is our first year running a varsity program, and it's my first year.
Choose Floratech Cleaning and Restoration, locally owned by Tom and Nancy Langdon since 1994, and because they offer so many services for residential and commercial properties, like carpet cleaning, mold testing and removal, fire and smoke damage, and duct cleaning. Floratech Cleaning and Restoration also offers emergency services in Yankton, Mitchell, Southeast South Dakota, Northeast Nebraska, and Norfolk.
Whether a broken pipe or flooding rains, when your home or floor is wet, call Floratech.
Located at 220 East 3rd Street in Yankton.
Horizon Healthcare in Yankton offers medical, dental, and behavioral health services for all, from tooth pains to aches and pains. Our new location on 920 Broadway Avenue is a comfortable, expanded space where everyone is welcome. Whether insured, uninsured, Medicaid, or Medicare, here in Yankton, we care for all, and that's what we care about most. Call to schedule your appointment at Horizon Healthcare.
Interior technicians.
I'm ready for my big role, Jerry.
What do you mean?
You said I'd be in your next 30 commercials.
No. I said InTech has over 30 years of commercial cleaning experience. You know, like offices, so they can ensure happy visitors and a healthy workforce.
So the shoot's in an office? I can make that work.
Oh my goodness. When you need it clean, call the InTech team.
Kaiser Heating and Cooling is your local source for heat and glow fireplaces, gas inserts, and wood stoves. Also home to the Trane HVAC systems, humidifiers, dehumidifiers, and mini splits. Whether building or remodeling, the team of experts will get you the right size of HVAC system for your home or business. The ductwork is made in-house, and then the installers will get your Trane system installed in no time to keep you cool in the summer and warm in the winter. Kaiser Heating and Cooling since 1948.
New year, new flooring. I plan on saying hello with new flooring from Larson Carpet in Yankton. Larson Carpet will help with design and installation. They have a great selection of carpet, vinyl, luxury vinyl plank, hardwood, and tile. Stop in and let them help you get a new look in the new year. Larson Carpet at 208 Walnut Street in the Meridian District in Yankton. For the best flooring for your space, lifestyle, and budget, see Larson Carpet.
Hello and welcome back to our Coach's Conversations on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube. I'm Zach Spear and a live interview here with head coach Jill Muth as we're currently watching the JV game. JV squad's doing pretty well so far, Jill.
Yeah, they are. Ava Gerard's been pitching really well for us, getting us off the field after just a couple, first two innings. I think she went 1-2-3, and so that's been a nice boost for her confidence to get her, some good positive innings and get her some confidence back. And then we've had some girls hit the ball. Boy, Eliza Gurney's had two big hits, and Madison Musfeld just had a hit. I'm just trying to remember. I haven't looked at the book closely. I'm trying to remember. Anyway, we're doing some nice things out there. So, yeah, it's fun to see the JV get to play in a game where they're ahead. They haven't had a win yet this year, so it's going to be nice, hopefully, if we can hang on and get this win for them.
And speaking of getting that first win, the varsity last night, we did see them end up getting their first win. How is the team feeling after that?
Oh, I think, the girls are excited, but we got a lot of seniors and, a lot of kids that played some varsity for us where they're like, okay, we got a win, now we're good, now we got to get back to work. We got two more games today that we want to go get two more wins and hopefully, get ourselves back to 500.
And now something I forgot to mention, we got to talk with Tori Hansen. She's the first Gazelle we've got to talk to post-game. She had a 5-pitch inning in the first inning. I mean, very good, and that's got to be a confidence boost there.
Wow, I didn't realize that. I knew it was fast. I didn't realize it was 5 pitches. Wow, good for her. Yeah, that's what we're wanting her to do, hit her spots, throw strikes, and let the defense hopefully help her out behind her. So that's fantastic.
And speaking of the defense, there was a couple errors last night, but I would say your defense played pretty solid, wouldn't you say?
I thought our third baseman and our shortstop made a couple of real nice plays for us, and we had Elena Nelson in one inning subbing for us, and she made a nice play on a line drive to second. So, yeah, I would think last night, we had a couple errors, and we got to clean that up and do what we need to do, but I thought overall, for the most part, our defense was okay.
And that is part of the game. You're going to have errors. You can't just expect no errors every single game. So I did think they did a nice job. And at third base, I had actually mentioned last night on stream, too, how well at third they were doing. And Elena Nelson, an immediate impact at second.
Yeah, absolutely. She came in and had a line drive that one inning and was kind of a last minute. We wanted to get Madison Gerard warmed up to get in. So I yelled, Nelson, get in there. And she was like, oh, okay. And so in she went. And, of course, the ball is how it always goes, right?
Oh, yeah.
The ball finds the newbie. So she did a nice job out there for us.
And so now coming up, it's the Spearfish Spartans. You and their team share the same record. What are your expectations for your team here?
I think we're going to make a little change. We're going to start Madison Gerard on the mound today just because we got two games. So we're just going to kind of mix it up a little bit. Our goal is to go out and throw strikes, make some plays behind her, and try to see if we can have some good at-bats.
And I'm glad you mentioned kind of shuffling around. That was my next question. With the two games today, is your roster going to be shuffling quite frequently, outside of pitching as well?
We're going to have a couple different spots that we're going to do some different things. We haven't finalized everything for the two games yet, but I think that's kind of something we're going to look at today, at least getting a couple girls, one start and kind of try to get to a point where we can solidify our roster or our lineup here.
Well, thank you so much, Coach, for the chat. As always, we'll go cheer on the JV as this game is coming close to an end. And then, of course, two games today. Noon is Spearfish, 4 is Pier. Look forward to it. More softball. Again, thank you.
All right. Thanks, Coach.
Again, that was head coach Jill Muth of the Yankton Gazelles live during the JV game. We'll be back in a moment. We have Spearfish and Yankton in what should be a very good game here today, exclusively on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Angel Crossing, located at 1101 Broadway Morgan Square in Yankton. Hi, it's Linda. Welcome to my store. The girls' department is sizes 2T to 14. The nursery holds Copper Pearl, Little Me Sleepers. The boys' department is 2T to 12. There's retro toys and little golden books. The ladies' department holds Tribal and Jag and Lulu B and jewelry and purses and your Yankton High School colors. Thank you for shopping Linda's Angel Crossing.
If you've fallen behind on your do-it-yourself projects at home and don't know where to start, Mead Lumber is your answer. Mead Lumber is your local stop for all things home improvement, from cabinetry to roofing. We have what you need for your next project. For over 100 years, Mead Lumber has been assisting customers with their home improvement needs, as well as assisting professional contractors, builders, and remodelers. The knowledgeable staff at Mead Lumber of Yankton will help you finish all your projects. Located at 2409 North Broadway, stop in today to see how Mead Lumber can help you.
Insurance Agency values family. Our agency has been family-run for over 60 years. We pride ourselves on excellent, knowledgeable customer service. This day and age, everyone is so eager to have an immediate response with a quote. But at Midwest Insurance, we take our time and evaluate your assets and make sure you are properly insured. We take those what-ifs very seriously. As we continue on our family business with hopes of our children, Brooke or Jet, taking over in the future, we will continue to be there for you always. Come be a part of our family. Midwest Insurance Agency, 3016 Piper Street, Yankton.
The Riverfront and Brewery Event Centers and Hotels Yankton has choices for a bride and groom and your wedding reception. Different spaces are available for your wedding reception, and the price is very competitive. Have your wedding reception where they offer you plenty of time for the decorating you and your family want to do, and plenty of time for cleanup, too. At the Riverfront and Brewery Event Centers and Hotels, you have 2.5-day venue that's all yours. See more by cruising the website, Riverfront and Brewery Event Centers and Hotels.
And back at Sertoma Park in Yankton, beautiful sunshiny day here as you hear the fight song for Yankton currently going on. We are moments away from the start of this game with the first pitch. All Yankton athletics are brought to you by First Dakota National Bank of Yankton. First Dakota has proudly supported the dreams and banking needs of their customers for over 150 years. They offer personal, business, and ag banking solutions for every stage of your journey with two locations, downtown and North Broadway, Yankton. Both teams are on the field, kind of huddled up next to each other. As we get to our starting lineups for today's game. Starting lineups are brought to you by Larry's Heating and Cooling of Yankton and Vermilion. For all your HVAC needs, it's Larry's Heating and Cooling, anytime, any day. So as they do on the field, we'll start with the visiting team on the starting lineups. As long as they don't go into the national anthem, but usually we get the lineups first. And they will, so we'll do the starting lineups as well. First, for the visiting Spearfish Spartans, they're coached by Bell Lubkin. And leading off is number 12 catcher Liv Johnson. She's followed by left fielder number 25 Emmy Johnson. Batting third, number 9 first base Danica Brown. In the cleanup spot, center fielder, it's number 33 Kiana Stalliker. In the 5 spot, another powerful hitter, number 21 designated hitter Amy Radcouture. Third base, to number 28, it's Skylar Wiesman. In the 7th spot, number 23, second baseman Taylor Tennant. After her, shortstop, number 6, Abby Feiereisen. And to round up the Spartans lineup, right fielder, number 11, Lainey O'Connell. On the mound for the Spartans will be number 5, Caitlin Sitzman. Reserves for the Spartans are number 1, Chloe Wiswell. Number 8, Maya Heiding. Number 10, Michaela Benson. Number 19, Taylor Eady. And number 24, Jaden Wenzel. Now for your home team, the Yankton Gazelles. Gazelles come into this one coached by Jill Muth. Leading off will be center fielder number 17, it's Emma Iacker. She's followed by left fielder number 20, Cameron Koletsky. In the 3 spot, shortstop number 21, Kyra Churchma. In the cleanup spot, catcher number 23, it's Peyton Mosier. In the 5 spot, first baseman number 24, Emma Herbolt. On the mound, starting her first game of the season, it's number 11, Madison Gerard. And the usual pitcher, who probably in relief for this game at second base, it's number 14, Tori Hansen. In the 8 spot, number 18, McKenna Hatchesky at third base. And to round up the Gazelles lineup, number 12, Haley Schulte in right field. Now, time for your national anthem. We'll keep it here. As you heard on the field, let's play ball. Batting first will be the Spearfish Spartans. Gazelles to take the field. Gazelles in their red jerseys, black pants, white numbers. And for Spearfish, they're wearing all white. White jerseys, white pants, and a kind of burgundy, deep red. I'm not super great with my colors. I think it's a burgundy, a dark burgundy probably is what you'd call it. Numbering and some trim on their jerseys as well. So the Gazelles now trot out onto the field. We are moments away from the first pitch. We'll be back in a moment with that first pitch on Five Star Streaming on YouTube.
You deserve to get good service and great rates. At State Farm, we get it, and we're here to help. Because with every State Farm policy, you get good neighbor service and surprisingly great rates. So what are you waiting for? Get going and talk to a local State Farm agent about your surprisingly great rates today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Individual premiums will vary by customer. All applicants subject to State Farm underwriting requirements. When you want the real deal, call State Farm agent Roy Wilcox in Yankton today.
Are you looking for your next great career opportunity? Then make it Sherco. A staple of the Yankton community, Sherco offers career opportunities in engineering, sales, marketing, accounting, tarp, metal fabrication, shipping, and assembly. Enjoy a year-round climate-controlled facility, 401k options, affordable health, dental, and vision care, paid time off, and 10 paid holidays. Make Sherco your next great opportunity. Learn more at sherco.com/careers.
As Mosier now makes her way onto the field, Gazelles warming up, getting ready. Coming off a win against Rapid City Central. And speaking of, I know Jill Muth and I talked about the JV game. The JV for Yankton did come out on top. They won 11-4. So congrats to the JV team with their first victory. As the Gazelles here now look to put up their second win in the left-hand category of wins-losses. Also, as you could tell, probably, you know, it was a live interview as at the end, Muth and I kind of were talking. I said, I'll try to not mess up as much as I can. She's like, oh, okay, I'll talk then. And at the end, she said, thanks, coach. And I was like, oh, well, you know, I don't mind being called coach. But, of course, I'm not a coach. But that's the beauty of live as this game is just about to go live. On Five Star Streaming on YouTube, I'm Zach Spear alongside Corbin Gunther. Corbin's going to be helping out with the stream today. Running my scoreboard as we await Madison Girard's first pitch. This first pitch is brought to you by the Move Group of Yankton. Now we're on the move with Mason Schramm and the Move Group Yankton. As the first pitch is fouled off, strike one. Leading off for the Spartans, it's Liv Johnson. On deck will be Emmy Johnson. And in the hole, Danica Brown. Girard on the mound rather than the usual Hanson. That pitch just misses up 1-1. Girard comes set, winds up, misses low and away. As again, it's Liv Johnson at the plate for the Spartans. As that pitch, a grounder right back up to Girard. She fields it cleanly. Throw was a little low, but caught by Herbolt at first for out number one. So the first out of the game, Girard will take herself on the mound. Emmy Johnson now batting. As the sisters lead off back-to-back here for the Spartans. Swing and a miss there for Emmy. One out, no runners on, 0-1 the count. Girard winds up. She's going to fire. Just a touch outside for ball one here. One ball, one strike here. Another swing and miss there from Emmy Johnson. So Girard finds herself up 1-2 in the count now. Both teams fighting for that second win on the season. Start righting the ship. The 1-2 pitch. That one's high, ball two. Girard. Back set as a swing and a miss, but the ball was dropped by Mosier. She'll get the throw to Herbolt. It will be a strikeout for Emmy Johnson. So two outs here, no runners on. Gazelle's defense starting out well. Danica Brown now at the plate with Kiana Staliker on deck. Top of the first inning here. Girard. Danica Brown doesn't get it. As one thing Muth and I have talked about is with their two pitchers between Girard and Hansen, it's not so much that you need to blow it by everybody, strike everybody out, but put the ball in play. Your defense will make plays. And that's exactly what happened yesterday. That pitch missed. It's 1-1 now the count. Girard. One misses outside. Two balls, one strike here. Two outs, no runners on. Spartans at the plate. Danica Brown awaiting the next pitch. Takes a cut, fouled it straight back into the net. Girard a chance to take this one herself as well. One strikeout here for her in the game in her first start of the season. And she gets number two, swinging and missing Danica Brown. So three up, three down. The Yankton Gazelles off to a hot start here in the top of the first inning. They hope to look that good at the plate when we return. Leading off will be Emma Iacker. She's followed by Cameron Kletzky on deck and Kyra Churchma in the hole. We'll be back in a moment for the bottom of the first inning in just a moment on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Visit our sleep experts at the Yankton Slumberland. With over 50 mattresses to choose from, we carry every price, free financing options, and the most trusted brands in the nation like Stearns & Foster, Sealy, and Tempur-Pedic. Snoring or lower back pain tormenting you? Seek relief with an adjustable power base. Fall asleep faster and cooler with our sheets and pillow selection. With a 120-night sleep trial, you can't make a mistake. See us today at the Yankton Slumberland, 2401 Broadway.
For the Gazelles, looking to take an early lead in this one, Emma Iacker will be at the plate to start the game. As still warming up are the Spartans. Maybe a little bit more time than I was expecting. As Iacker and Kaletsky both outside the dugout, trying to time up on the mound, Caitlin Sitzman. So Iacker, the leadoff hitter for the Gazelles. Yankton in their first game of two today. So Iacker, the first Gazelle to face up against Caitlin Sitzman on the mound. The first pitch, Eicher gets a piece of it. Fouls it off. Behind the plate here is Liv Johnson for the Spartans. Sitzman, the next pitch on the way. Eicher watches it. It's high, ball one. It's one ball, one strike here. Eicher fouled off the first pitch. Got a piece of that one. Straight back out of play. One ball, two strikes here. As Sitzman trying to get the first out for her team here. The windup, the pitch, misses high. 2-2 is the count. Eicher looking to be a leadoff runner for her team. Kaletsky awaits on deck. As that pitch low, Eicher finds herself with a 3-2 count, and Emma really didn't get much of a chance to bat yesterday. She was hit by pitch all three of her at-bats in last night's game. So three beans for Eicher. She's probably hoping to not take three today, but it's that anyway on mentality. 3-2, the pitch. It's low. Eicher's walked. She's headed to first. So Cameron Kaletsky now has a runner on first for her. On deck, Kyra Churchmo with Peyton Mosier in the hole. So Kaletsky had a base hit in yesterday's game, looking to replicate that. Eicher still on first. First pitch, taken strike for Kaletsky. Sitzman with a nice spot. Caitlin comes set, winds up, has that one outside. Eicher gets a pretty aggressive leadoff of first after the pitch is thrown usually, as you saw Liv kind of look her down, look her back to first. As Kaletsky takes that pitch, it's low and inside, ball two. So 2-1 the count now here for Cameron Kaletsky at the plate. The runner on first. As she got a piece of that one, fouls it back into the net. 2-2 now the count. As a pretty full crowd here today, especially for a noon game, but the beautiful weather, people take off a little early from work or just take the day off. As the pitch to Kaletsky, a hard hit grounder off of the glove. She'll be standing on first. On second is Eicher. One of those tough ones you hate to technically call an error, but would say it is. So Kaletsky reaches by error, but nonetheless a very tough one. At third, as Skylar Wiesman would have had to make a fantastic play there. Runners on first and second, it's Kyra Churchma at the plate. Churchma takes the first pitch, it's called for a strike, 0-1 the count. Runners on first and second though. Yankton threatening to score here, Churchma has one in scoring position, that one inside, ball one. Mosier on deck with no outs. Doesn't need to worry too much about the catcher's equipment as Churchma line drive right to center field. It's caught by Kiana Staliker. Got a good piece of it, but Staliker was in the right position just awaiting that one in her glove. Peyton Mosier now at the plate. Mosier, her first at bat of the game. Mosier watches that one go by high. Ball one. The 1-0 pitch. That one high from Sitzman. 2-0. Mosier, a good hitter for her team. Couple of base hits on the season for her. As she gets a piece of that one, fouls it off out of play. Two balls, one strike here, one out. Runners are on first and second here for the Gazelles in the bottom of the first, trying to be the first team to score here in this one. The 2-1 pitch from Sitzman hits the inside zone. Mosier, no swing. Sitzman trying to get her team out of this situation. A strikeout here would help Spearfish greatly. As Sitzman just misses outside. Mosier thought about that one long and hard, decided against it. And that'll make the count full. Hard one to sit on, but Mosier with the right call. Full count. As Mosier, a grounder hit over to second. It's picked up. They'll get the out at second. Mosier will be standing on first with a fielder's choice. Kaletsky out at second. As the play was made by Taylor Tennant of Spearfish. Herbolt has runners on first and third here. Two outs. As Herbolt still trying to find that first base hitter on the season, but she's gotten on base multiple times. Thought about it, decided against it. Mosier's going to take off for second. She has it with no challenge from Liv Johnson behind the plate. Pitch was a ball, 1-0 is the count. The windup from Sitzman. Herbolt got a piece of it into shallow right field. It's going to land. Herbolt has a base hit. She's going to score for the Gazelles, too, as she ends up standing on second with a double. Gazelles score two runs here off of the Herbolt double. Just what the Gazelles needed right away. So Iacher scores from third. Mosier scores from second. Now batting Madison Girard. She's been on the mound here for her team. Girard takes the first pitch, hits the outside zone for strike one. Again, after the big hit from Emma Herbolt, with shallow right field, just kind of in between enough where no one could get to it. That pitch high, ball one. So Girard on her first official start here of the season on the mound has looked good so far. Two of the three outs were at her hand with a strikeout. As she gets a line drive grounder right back up the middle, scooped up by third, and headed for home is Herbolt. Herbolt's out. Gazelles get a little greedy. Madison Girard is going to be credited with a base hit. As that one, not really much of a chance for Sitzman on the mound. It bounced off her leg. But Herbolt trying to go home, score a third run for the Gazelles. She won't have it. So after one inning of play, 2-0, Gazelles on top, but the Spartans at the plate. When we come back, it'll be Kiana Staliker with Amy Rad-Couture on deck. We'll be back in a moment on 5 Stars Streaming on YouTube.
Doctors Lane and Reed Sawatsky make up the team at SWAT Chiropractic and Rehab. Located at 800 Mariner Lane on the way out to the lake, we combine chiropractic with soft tissue treatments and rehabilitative exercise to custom tailor each individual patient experience. From sports injuries to sciatic nerve pain, we are here to help you move better and get back to doing what you love. SWAT Chiropractic, specialized wellness and therapy.
Back here for the top of the second inning. Leading off again for the Spartans is Kiana Staliker, Amy Rad-Couture on deck. In the hole, Skylar Wiesman, Madison Gerard on the mound here. For the Gazelles, as always, it's Peyton Mosier behind home plate. As that one hit high up into right field, Schulte is able to come down with it. So four up, four down here. Gazelles defense playing well. So I think I heard them say Rad-Couture, not Rad-Couture. First pitch from Gerard, a ball, 1-0 the count. Gerard winds up. That one fouled up into the net. Nearly out of play, but 1-1 the count now. One down, no runners on here. On our Fox Top scoreboard, it's 2-0 favoring the Gazelles. An off-speed pitch from Gerard fools Couture at the plate. One ball, two strikes here. So the next pitch taken for a ball. And we asked some Spearfish locals. It is Rad-Couture. As she's going to ground that foul on the first base side. 2-2, the count remains. Next pitch from Gerard, as that one's launched into deep right field, going back. It's going to be over Haley Schulte's head. Couture headed for second. She's going to round it and stay on second. A stand-up double, though, for Amy Rad-Couture. The first base hit here of the game for the Spartans, and just the jump they needed, as now Skylar Wiesman at the plate has a runner in scoring position. Taylor Tennant on deck. Gerard's first pitch is low. Ball one. As that one fouled straight back. One ball, one strike. So as we thought, probably a good game coming up today, as these two teams have the same record. That pitch high from Gerard, 2-1. So Wiesman has seen one good pitch. She fouled it off in this at bat. Gerard's pitch there does hit the outside zone. Two balls, two strikes here. Next pitch, does get a piece of Wiesman. She's standing on first after getting beaned, as that is the first one of the game for either team. Runners now on first and second. Fresh count for Taylor Tennant, her first time at bat of the day. On deck, Abby Feiereisen. Gerard's pitch, a strike. One out, showing sign of bunt. She does try to get it down. It's back foul. So two strikes here. We'll see if Tennant still tries the bunt. Kind of a risky move when you have those two strikes on you. As that one fouled straight back, as Tennant not going to be bunting. Count still at 0-2. has that one. Fouled out of play. Tennant really making Girard work on the mound right now. Next pitch. As that's line drive right into left field. Kaletsky picks it up. No score for Spearfish, but a base hit. As Tennant standing on first with a single. Base is now loaded for Abby Feiereisen. Two base hits here for the Spartans. Scoring opportunity for Spearfish. Girard and the Gazelles some work to do to try and get out of this situation. Pretty much anything in the infield you got to take home with you. As a grounder there picked up by Churchma. She's going to touch on second. The throw to first won't be there in time. So one scores for the Spartans. Feiereisen on first with a fielder's choice. As scoring was Rad Couture. Skylar Wiesman to third. Tennant out at second with Lainey O'Connell batting. She has runners on first and third, two outs. As the steal to second, as looked like the Gazelles were maybe trying to lure the Spartans to running home, but taking second is Feiereisen. One ball, no strikes. That one hits the outside zone for strike one. Gazelle's trying to hang on to that lead as Spearfish has put up a run here in the second inning. As that one lofted up, it's going to be above Churchma's head. A base hit, scoring two for the Spartans. As now taking off for second. The throw made it in time. Not caught, though. So O'Connell with a single, now standing on second, scores two. Wiesman crosses home plate. Feiereisen scores. Runner on second, three base hits here, three runs for Spearfish at the plate. Gazelles call a timeout. It's a Lindsay Echowater Systems of Yankton timeout. Locally owned for four generations. Call them for water softening, reverse osmosis needs, and bottled water. 665-7471, 209 East 3rd Street in Yankton. Okay. Thank you. And again, on our Fox Stop scoreboard, the score is 3-2. The Fox Stop at the corner of West City Limits Road and 31st in Northwest Yankton, open 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. daily. A full-service convenience store with hot food, sandwiches, munchies, and beverages. Pay at the pump, gas and diesel fuel, and firewood and propane tank exchange. So Spearfish, now back to the top of their lineup. It's Liv Johnson with a runner on second, trying to trade places. First pitch inside and low, ball one. Liv Johnson grounded out in the first inning. As she's got a base hit here. It's into left field as no score for Spearfish, though. As Liv Johnson standing on first. Now on third is Lainey O'Connell. Four base hits here in the inning for the Spartans. Now Emmy Johnson at the plate with Danica Brown on deck. So Spearfish taking the lead back now, top of the second inning. As a dribbler right back up to Girard. She's going to make the throw, and that will put the top of the second inning to rest, but not before Spearfish puts up three runs of their own. When we return, the Yankton Gazelles look to take that lead right back. Leading off will be Tori Hansen with McKenna Hatcheski on deck and Haley Schulte in the hole. We'll be back in a moment for the bottom of the second inning here on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Looking for your first home? How about your next home? Maybe a vacation home. The Move Group is a full-service real estate brokerage operating in South Dakota, primarily servicing the Yankton and Sioux Falls, South Dakota areas. Having the knowledge and the drive to help you make the right purchase to suit you and your needs. When buying or selling a home, Mason at The Move Group is ready to get you the results you are looking for. Call us today. We're ready to work for you. Make the move with the Move Group.
After 1.5 innings of play, on top is Spearfish, 3-2. Gazelles scored 2 in the first inning, took the early lead, and now Spartans took the lead in the second with 3 runs of their own off of 4 base hits. So leading off, Torrey Hansen for the Gazelles. Hansen's been at second base today rather than her usual spot on the mound. Thought about it, decided against it. It's low, ball one. So the 7-8-9 batters here for Yankton. Sits Min. Hansen got a good piece of it into right field. That one's dropping. Torrey Hansen has a base hit. She's standing on first. A leadoff hit and a leadoff runner now for the Gazelles. Their third base hit here of the game. And that's already matched 2 of their game totals. So hitting has been an area of improvement here for Yankton. Now at the plate, it's McKenna Hatchiski. Hatchiski with a runner on first here. That first pitch low. Taking off for second is Hansen. The throw won't make it. Hansen on second. Safe. And the pitch was a ball, so 1-0 the count. No outs here. Hansen now on second, a great opportunity for the Gazelles to tie it up. As that pitch, outside zone, strike one. 1-1 now the count. One ball, one strike here. Hatchiski got a piece of that one, fouled it into the net. One ball, two strikes here. Sitzman has an opportunity for her first strikeout on the mound today. She's walked one, has been pretty accurate for most of the day. As Hatchiski, a blooper, that's going to be caught by Taylor Tennant at second. Had to go a distance. It nearly just nearly made it to center field, but it's going to be caught. Hatchiski will be out. Hansen remains on second. Haley Schulte now batting with Emma Iacker on deck. So with one out, Schulte looking to advance her team's runner. She does get a bunt down the third base line, but it's going to drift foul. Looked like a very good bunt, but just a little bit too much to that side. So 0-1 now the count. Spearfish moving up at third. We'll see if Schulte goes for the bunt again or not. Here's the windup. She won't. Takes that, misses outside. 1-1. So far, this game has been as promised, a good one. As Schulte takes a cut, doesn't get it. One ball, two strikes now. Sitzman has found her rhythm here pitching. She's going to force the Gazelles to have to. If they want to score and get on base, they're going to have to hit the ball. That pitch scooped up by Liv Johnson, 2-2. The windup, the next pitch. Haley Schulte looked like she maybe wanted it, but she's going to let that go. It was high. Full count now, 3 balls, 2 strikes, 1 out, a runner on second for Schulte. On deck, Emma Iacker. Next pitch on the way from Sitzman. Schulte lines it into left field. A base hit. Hanson takes off. It gets by left field. Hanson's going to head home and tie this ball game up. Schulte's on second. She's headed for third. She's going to have a stand-up triple here. Tori Hanson ties the ball game up, crossing home. Schulte with a nice base hit down the third baseline into left field. She's got a triple. Four base hits now for the Gazelles. Emma Iacker at the plate, already for the second time of the game. She's 0-for-0 technically in her last four at-bats. In her last four, she's been beaten three times and walked, as we last saw in the first inning. That pitch wild gets to the backstop. Haley Schulte stays on third, though. So a tie ball game now here. Iacker has the chance to get the lead back for her team. Thought about that one, decided against it. It was high and outside. Ball two. Sitzman fires the next one. That's high for Iacker. Iacker now faces a 3-0 count, and it's starting to feel like people don't want to pitch to her as she gets on frequently by walk or bean, either or, as that pitch misses, and Iacker still 0-for-0 technically, but she's walked on first now. Runners on first and third for Cameron Koletsky. Batting now. On deck is Kyra Churchma. But Koletsky reached by error in the first inning. A base hit for sure scores one here for the Gazelles. As Iacker takes off for second, the throwdown will go to third, though. Keep Schulte there. Iacker safe at second. Pitch was called a strike. Koletsky no swing. She probably got the take sign from coach. But Koletsky, one of those players, she usually does kind of take the first pitch no matter where it's at, of what I've seen so far this season anyways. As Koletsky takes a cut at that one, misses 0-2 the count. Churchma waits on deck. And in the hole, Peyton Mosier. Sitzman winds up to Koletsky. That one high and outside. So one ball, two strikes here. Sitzman, the next pitch. Koletsky, a hard hit grounder to shortstop. The throw gets there in time, but a sacrifice hit from Koletsky. That will not count against her batting average. It scores Haley Schulte for the lead for the Gazelles. Iacker to third, two outs now. But again, Koletsky on first, or was thrown out at first with a sacrifice grounder. Usually a sac fly, but now batting Kyra Churchma. Two outs here. There is a runner on third, though, so Gazelles could add on to the lead. First pitch a ball. They've scored two in both of their innings at the plate so far with two base hits. The 1-0 pitch from Sitzman. Churchma gets a piece of this one high up into center field, as tracking it and catching it is Kiana Staliker. Staliker has caught both of Churchma's hits to center field so far today, as the Gazelles do reclaim that lead, but not by much, 4-3, as when we return, the Spartans leading off is Danica Brown in a moment on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Hi, this is Clay.
And Rachel.
From the Red Hydrant Inn and Playground in Yankton.
We offer daycare, boarding, grooming, and training for all breeds of dogs.
We are the one-stop shop for all dog necessities. Treats, toys, collars, leashes, and more.
Your dog is family, and we treat them like our own.
Give us a call at 665-7297 or stop in 2901 Broadway in Yankton. We can't wait to meet you and your pet. Again, 665-7297.
Make it a double. No, make it a triple. Triple Time Rudy's in Yankton. Stop for premium, ethanol, or regular gas anytime with pay at the pump. Or stop in during regular hours to find the meats, cheeses, beverages, snacks to fuel you up. There's oil, grease, and more for your vehicles, gift cards, an unbeatable staff, and just the right amount of that personal service. Make it a Triple Time Rudy's, corner of 17th and Broadway, Yankton.
So Danica Brown will lead things off for the Spartans as they look to get that run back. They trail 4-3 on her Fox Stop scoreboard. Gazelles on top in the field. Girard first pitch well low, a ball. Danica Brown struck out in the first inning, looking to get a base hit here and be a leadoff runner for the Spartans. Has that one. Well, Danica Brown got hit by that one. She's standing on first with a bean. Now the second batter hit by pitch in the game as Kiana Staliker has a runner on for her. Amy Radcatur on deck. Staliker flew out to right field to lead off the second inning. Takes the first pitch, called for ball one. That one off of the plate made it really tough for Mosier, as even if she's trying to block that forward, just kind of bounced over her. That's the issue when it hits the front of the plate. So advancing to second is Danica Brown. Staliker still hasn't had to swing, as it's a 2-0 count. Has that one just outside, 3-0 now the count. As there, Girard does find the strike zone, 3-1. Staliker still with the chance to be kind of picky at the plate here. Girard trying to force that. As into center field, Spearfish going home as they're going to score and tie this game up after the base hit from Staliker. Danica Brown scores. All of a sudden, it's 4-4 again. A tie ball game. Staliker on first. Radcatur at the plate. She's 1-for-1. Hit a double in the second inning. On deck, Skylar Wiesman. As Jill Muth wants to head to the mound, as Girard will be swapped out in favor of Tori Hansen. Again, it's another Lindsay Echo Water Systems of Yankton timeout. We're going to take the timeout as well. Give Hansen a moment to warm up here on the mound. When we return, though, at the plate for the Spartans will be Amy Radcatur.
Are you looking for a cool place to work? Look no further than Tuxedo. Not only does Tuxedo have a cool, positive, and people-oriented culture, but the building is climate-controlled, too. Check out the many job opportunities at Tuxedo. They are looking for a receiving supervisor, weekend production supervisor, weeknight shipping clerk, and weekday and weekend production positions. Apply at realtruck.com/careers. Tuxedo of Yankton. Working for a successful global business with customers in 140 countries. That's Vishay Intertechnology, a Fortune 1000 maker of electronic componentry. Now imagine a company of that size with that kind of stability and a caring family-like environment. Learn more about what you can do at Vishay by visiting VishayCareers.com. Vishay is an equal opportunity employer. Vishay, the DNA of tech.
And as we come back, we missed one pitch as Radcatur swung, didn't get a piece of it, so 0-1 the count here. No outs, has a runner on first, got a piece of that one, straight back, so make the count 0-2. As Hansen really only needed about maybe three warm-up pitches, she didn't need much time on the mound there. So no balls, two strikes, no outs here. Gazelle's trying to keep this a tie ball game. Mosier pump fakes over to first. Staliker jogs back. So Radcatur, again, she had that double in the second inning, trying to replicate that. Faces a 1-2 count against, now it's Tori Hansen again on the mound. Has that one just outside. Hansen working against the first batter she's seen so far on the mound today. As that one's hit up, Mosier has a chance at it. She'll catch it for out number one here in the third inning. Skylar Wiesman at the plate. She was hit by a pitch in the second inning. On deck is Taylor Tennant, who's one for one today. Still on first is Staliker. And for the Gazelles, just feels good to get that first out here in the third inning as that one's lofted high up into right center. Iacher gets there. She makes the grab. She's going to throw it to first. We have a chance at a double play. As they're going to call safe at first. Herbal did make the grab, was taken out. Staliker just barely made it back. What a play in center, though. Or shouldn't even say center field. It was right center for sure. But Iacher being able to track that down, making the throw to Herbal. Two down now. Taylor Tennant at the plate. As now, looks like Muth wants to make sure she thought that the throw made it for sure in time at first. As the officials talking things over, we'll see what the call is. They are going to declare Staliker safe at first. So a close play at first would have been a double play to wrap up the top of the third. Instead, Taylor Tennant at the plate here for Spearfish. Swing and a miss there. Mosier's going to throw it down to first. Throws on the opposite side. So Herbert kind of had to swing her body around. Tag doesn't make it in time. 0-1 the count, though, for Tennant. That one just kind of felt like the Gazelles maybe thought they should have had it, so wanted to get her out at first that time. No balls, one strike here. Two outs. That pitch just misses outside. The count, 1-1. Tennant working against Hansen. That pitch low. Mosier's going to throw it again to Herbolt. The throw was low, though, so Staliker takes off for second, slides a little beyond second base. You know, maybe if that throws to Herbolt, she's probably able to get it over to second in time, but it was off the ground, kind of into Herbolt's stomach. Bounced off. Staliker able to make it to second. And swing and a miss there. Tennant. Now 2-2 in the count. So next pitch. Just high, making the count full for Hansen and Tennant. Hansen winds up. The 3-2 pitch is outside for ball four. So standing on first is Tennant with a walk. Staliker still on second with Abby Feireisen at the plate. Lainey O'Connell on deck. First pitch called for strike one, 0-1. As I'm trying to decipher from my own writing, I wrote an F. I either didn't finish the FC for fielder's choice or didn't finish the E for error. But the Gazelles with no errors, she got on by fielder's choice. A steal for third, throw easily makes it in time, as that'll be out number three. Staliker caught. Mosier with a good throw down, as I'll fill in that spot. When we return, as Abby Feireisen will bat to start the fourth inning, as she didn't get a full at bat. When we return, though, the Gazelles at the plate trying to take the lead back here. It's 4-4. Peyton Mosier will be on the plate.
Simple sniffles to complex health conditions. The primary care providers at Yankton Medical Clinic will not only see you for your annual visits, screenings, and preventative care, but also provides care for the entire family, from pediatrics to adults. With 4 clinic locations and 15 outreach locations throughout South Dakota and Nebraska, compassionate, quality medical care is closer than you think. For more information on providers, services, and locations, visit our website, yanktonmedicalclinic.com.
good ball game, good weather, and a great Friday. Sure beats being in an office out in this, I don't know, maybe 60-degree weather with the sun shining, watching a great game of softball between these two teams. So far, been evenly matched. We head into the bottom of the fourth inning here with Peyton Mosier leading off for the Gazelles. On deck, Emma Herbolt and Madison Girard in the hole. That first pitch outside. Caitlin Sitzman still on the mound for Spearfish here. As that one fouled straight back by Mosier. Mosier reached off of a fielder's choice in the first inning. Trying to get her first base hit, a line drive, roped hard into right field. It's to the fence, over the right fielder's head. Mosier headed for second. She's going to have third. We'll see by the time the ball gets in. Mosier's going to take home the throw. Doesn't make it. Peyton Mosier with the first home run of the season for the Gazelles. She has an in-the-park home run. Gazelles on top. That's the best way to start an inning right there. Peyton Mosier is going to take all four as a hard-hit line drive was able to make it over the head of Lainey O'Connell. Mosier roped that one into right field. And she is the cleanup hitter, of course, for the Gazelles. So now 1-for-2 in the game. Emma Herbolt batting. She's 1-for-1, had a double earlier. 5 base hits here for the Gazelles. 5-4 on the Fox Stop scoreboard. So Herbolt, the first pitch to her. Hits the inside zone. Sitzman with a strike, 0-1 the count. Herbolt took a cut at that one, didn't get it. 0-2 now the count. Couldn't tell if she fouled it or if that was the sound of the ball in the dirt. Either way, no balls, 2 strikes here. Yankton's put up 1 run to take the lead here in the bottom of the third. Herbolt watches that, it's outside, ball 1. Girard awaits on deck. Girard's 1-for-1. So some good numbers at the plate so far for a lot of the Gazelles. Next pitch also misses outside. Count now knotted up at 2-2. No outs, no runners on here. Herbolt, the second batter of the inning for the Gazelles. The windup from Sitzman. Herbolt swings, doesn't get it, but it makes it to the backstop. Herbolt takes off for first as she's going to be thrown out. Another very close play at first. Herbolt was maybe half a step too late. Madison Girard at the plate. Sitzman does find the strike zone with that one. Tori Hansen on deck. So the two pitchers of the team back-to-back in the batting order for the Gazelles. As Girard gets a piece of that one over to second, picked up. Throw good over to first, out number 2. So Tori Hansen now faces 2 outs, no runners on. Tori Hansen's 1-for-1 in the game. Tori Hansen, she'll take the first pitch, called for a strike. as after those last two, looks like Sitzman on the mound has fired nothing but strikes, it seems. And Hansen going to hold off on that one. So one ball, one strike here. Hatcheski on deck, Haley Schulte in the hole. As that one high, 2-1. So far, every inning, the Gazelles, for each hit, they've scored a run. They have five hits, five runs. That pitch misses high for ball three. 3-1 the count with two outs. Hansen trying to reach the plate, trying to reach first for the second time of the day. Sometimes you just get a little too ahead of yourself. Sitzman, that one, Hansen fouls straight back. The count now full. Another full count here in the bottom of the third. Caitlin Sitzman, the full count, winds up, fires it, as that one's hit out of play, fouled off. Nearly landing in the trash can next to the other field. Another 3-2 pitch from Sitzman, as it's low and inside. Hansen takes off for first. So McKenna Hatcheski batting here. On deck, Haley Schulte. As we're going to have a pinch runner for Hansen. As it's Madison Musfelt now on first. Hatcheski 0-for-1 today. Had that hit that was near second. And a good play made by Taylor Tennant. As that was one I thought was going to reach center field. Just quite couldn't. Sitzman. At pitch, outside. Hatcheski. Awaiting a pitch to swing at here. Has that one high. Ball two. Two balls, no strikes here. Sitzman has pitched the first 2 2/3 innings, trying to close out the third here. That pitch high, so Hatcheski faces a 3-0 count here with two outs. It's Musfelt on first in place of Torrey Hansen. Of course, a pinch runner, as Hansen is the pitcher currently for the Gazelles. Next pitch. Finds the strike zone, 3-1 the count. Three balls, one strike, two outs, one runner on first for Hatcheski. She takes a cut, fouls that one out of play. Made some decent contact there, though. The 3-2 count. It's going to walk Hatcheski over to first. So now Hansen... Well, Musfeld in place of Hansen on second. Hatcheski on first with a walk. Haley Schulte, 1-for-1 in the game, had that triple in the second inning. Has runners in scoring position, one anyways. Schulte takes a cut, fouls that one straight back. So 0-1 the count, Schulte faces, gets a piece of that one, fouls it straight back as well. Bottom of the third inning, Gazelles have a one-run lead, 5-4. Two runners on. Schulte now down 0-2 in the count. A nice piece of that one. It's going to drop. The play won't be made, so base is now loaded for leadoff hitter Emma Iacker. Schulte reaches by error over to second as Hatcheski Musfelt in place of Hansen on third. So Iacker has been walked twice in this game. A walk would score a run. As she takes the first pitch for a called strike. Sitzman trying to avoid giving up any more runs here to Yankton. The 0-1 count. As Iacker gets a piece of that, it's into right field. And it's going to be snagged out there by Lainey O'Connell. So the Gazelles will finish the inning with just one run scored. Iacker flies out. When we return, Spartans at the plate. Batting will be Abby Feiereisen in a moment on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Yankton Rexall, located in the Meridian District, downtown Yankton, has Hallmark cards and keepsake ornaments. They carry many different items for that wedding, anniversary, or special birthday, along with collectibles like Precious Moments and Willow Tree. The pharmacy is home to the ever-popular Med Packs, and the toy store offers Melissa and Doug toys, Abdallah chocolates, and Sweet Shop candy. When you want something perfect for gift giving, find it at Yankton Rexall in the Meridian District on 3rd Street.
Fight the wait when your furnace and AC needs repair by joining Larry's Heating and Cooling, Comfort Care, and Elite Care Club. Larry's Comfort Care Club features seasonal maintenance discounts on service and no overtime charges. Larry's Elite Club includes seasonal maintenance, free parts, free labor, free service calls, and both mean you are in front of the line for service. Call Larry's Heating and Cooling and sign up for the Comfort Care or Elite Care Club. Larry's Heating and Cooling, Yankton and Vermilion.
And so Hansen's first pitch, that one a grounder up the middle for a base hit, a leadoff hit for Abby Feiereisen, standing on first with a single. Talk about instant action, one pitch, one base hit here. So now a base runner on for Lainey O'Connell, who made that play in right field earlier. First pitch. That one's hit up, and it's going to be into the outfield. Another base hit here, so two hits now for the Spartans. And that actually looks like it's Maya Heiding in for Lainey O'Connell. So over to second is Feiereisen. Maya Heiding will be on first with a single. Runners on first and second. That brings up the top of the lineup, Liv Johnson. So Spearfish. Good opportunity for them to score here. Two runners on with no outs. Liv Johnson right back up the middle. Another base hit as another single as Spearfish is going to have bases loaded. So three straight hits for Spearfish. No runs. We'll see if the bend don't break defense from the Gazelles can come into effect here. Bases loaded with no outs. Anything to the outfield should for sure score at least one for Spearfish. Emmy Johnson at the plate, 0-2 so far today, but wouldn't matter if she's able to get a base hit here. First pitch from Hansen, a strike. As a swing and a miss there, Mosier has to go pick it up, but kept it close enough where no real threat of any of the runners trying to take off. Emmy Johnson down 0-2 in the count here. Hansen trying to take her herself as that one's fouled straight back. So the count remains 0-2. Hansen, a little bit more freedom on the mound to do what she would like. Has a few pitches to waste. the windup, as that one's fouled back as well. Emmy Johnson forcing Hansen to work on the mound. Hansen, though, has thrown four straight good pitches here to Emmy Johnson. Johnson just keeps fouling him back and forcing her to throw more. Hansen trying to get one by her here. As that one's lofted into left field, a fourth straight base hit here. As at third, the throw makes it, so the Gazelles do get an out. As FireEisen able to score, tie this game up. Maya hiding out at third. Liv Johnson now on second with Emmy Johnson on first, a single. That's four straight singles hit by Spearfish. So Coach Lupkin out talking with the umpire, the base umpire, as they'll have a discussion here between the two officials. As this is the second time that we've had a coach challenging one of the calls on the field early. So we'll just wait. They're going to change the call. So no outs on third is Maya hiding. So bases are still loaded, no outs here. Spearfish, a great offensive set here so far. Top of the fourth inning, Spartans have put up one run so far, but they have bases loaded still and no outs. So they've got a really good chance to put up more and start leading this game. A dribbler back up to Hansen. Hansen makes the throw to Mosier at home. They get the lead runner. And on field, Danica Brown standing on first with a fielder's choice. Out at home is Maya hiding. That time she's definitely out. Liv Johnson now to third, Emmy Johnson on second, Danica Brown on first. So Gazelles get that first much-needed out. So anything goes home or a chance at a double play if it's in the infield here. Hansen, a swing and a miss there as Kiana Stalliker took a big cut at that one. 5-5 is your score. Have a feeling this one's going the full seven, no questions asked, and it might come down to the last pitch as that one hits shallow in the infield as Churchma unable to grab it. Spearfish takes the lead off of the error. So Stalliker on first after the error committed by the Gazelles. And a very, very rare error by Churchma at shortstop. She's been about as good of a defender as you can ask for. That pitch high and away. Again, it's Amy Radcouture at the plate. That pitch low for ball two. 2-0 now the count. No room to put any batters on base, so gotta make sure. The only way they score is putting in play, as a good piece of that one is Radcouture, as it's going to land right in front of the fence, foul. So 2-1 the count, but Radcouture got a good chunk of that one. One hop to the fence, just wasn't in play. Even if she hits that right at Koletsky, it's going to score another one. Pitches outside, ball three. So three balls, one strike, one out, bases are loaded. Amy Radcouture, she's 1-for-2 on the day, has a double. Flew out to Mosier in her last appearance at the plate. Got a good piece on her foul ball as she ropes out a line drive into left field. Spearfish scores another. So Emmy Johnson crosses home plate. Danica Brown to third. On second is Stalliker. Radcouture has a single, her second base hit of the game, the fifth for Spearfish here in this fourth inning. So now again, the Gazelles with a timeout, a Lindsay Echo Water Systems of Yankton timeout. The updated score now 7-5 with Spearfish on top. That is the largest lead they've had in the game so far, two runs, as the Gazelles have scored a run at each of their appearances at the plate. Spearfish has scored in three of their four innings. Spartans have been hitting very well today. As there is a substitution, wondering if I totally missed it here. It will be Skylar Wiesman batting. As it does look like we'll have a pinch runner on first for Rad Couture. As they're going to say, nope. So it was Chloe Wiswell was going to come in and run. She gets sent back to the dugout. Base is still loaded with one out here. That one's lofted into right field. Schulte tracking it. She in and out of the glove. It's an error by the Gazelles, as that'll score one more for Spearfish. Base is still loaded. They're headed for home. They're going to make it. They score two on that. So Danica Brown crosses home. Staliker crosses home. Rad Couture over to second. Standing on first is Wiesman after the error. So two errors by the Gazelles here in this inning. Taylor Tennant at the plate, and on deck is Fireisen, who led off this inning for Spearfish. First pitch low and inside, 9-5 here. The biggest lead now by either team so far in the game. Plenty of game time left, though, as it's only top of the fourth inning here. That pitch, high and away. Two balls, no strikes, one out here. Yankton needing another one. That one's lofted high up. Herbolt gets under it. She does come down with it. So two outs now as Taylor Tennant flies out. And Abby Fireisen, her second at bat here now. In the inning, she had a single earlier, was the first run scored for her team in this one. Fireisen takes a cut, doesn't get it. 0-1, now two outs. Runners on first and second here. Yankton trying to do some damage control. As she gets a piece of that one, fouls it off into the net. Behind it, 0-2 now the count. If you're the Gazelles, really hoping to just get it here, you go into the bottom of the fourth. It's only a four-run deficit. Spearfish still looking to add more, though. As that one just misses outside. One ball, two strikes here. Hansen likes the pitch call, comes set, winds up. That one's well outside. 2-2 now the count. So five runs scored here in the top of the fourth for Spearfish. Swing and a miss there, as now the inning comes to a close, the top half of the inning, I should say. But Gazelles now trail four runs. They've got some work to do. Koletsky to lead off when we return on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Nice.
Maytag appreciates the compliment, but this Maytag washer isn't just eye candy.
Wow.
Inside, it's got the capacity and power to handle even the mightiest loads.
I love this.
Yeah, she's a beaut.
It's a he.
How do you know?
Don't worry about it.
Find Maytag products and the industry's best appliances at your local dealer, Murph's Appliance, downtown Vermilion.
Gazelles now with some runs to make up of their own. Cameron Koletsky to lead off. On deck will be Kyra Churchma and Peyton Mosier in the hole. Three very, very capable hitters for the Gazelles here to lead off the bottom of the fourth inning. At the halfway point, though, it's 9-5 on our Fox Top scoreboard. Spearfish on top. Spartans with a great burst there in that top of the fourth inning. Had a great inning of play. That pitch low and inside. Koletsky, no swing. Ball one. Yankton needs to get a leadoff runner. Koletsky, that one's high for her. 2-0 now the count. Sitzman winds up. Koletsky got a piece of that one. Dead ball, though. Bounced off her leg. Two balls, one strike here. Koletsky at the plate. Gets a good piece of that one. A line drive grounder up the middle, as that'll be a base hit. Kyra Churchma will have a runner on first in Koletsky, as Koletsky gets a much needed hit here for the Gazelles. Churchma in this game 0 for 2. She's flown out twice to center fielder Staliker. As she takes the first pitch, it's a strike. You know, she'd probably love to get one over Staliker after she's caught the last two of hers. One to the fence might even score Koletsky from first. As Churchma ropes that one. That's high, deep left center, and it doesn't quite make it. Bounces off the fence. Koletsky's headed for home. The throw isn't going to make it. Koletsky's safe. A double for Churchma. And I just about got ahead of myself and declared a home run as Churchma's bounces. It doesn't bounce off the ground. Bounced off the fence. It was a no-hopper to the fence. Just ever so close, would have been the first one over the fence for the Gazelles on the season. Peyton Mosier, though, now has a runner on second for her. Takes the first pitch high, it's a ball. Score now 9-6. Pitch outside, 2-0 the count. Peyton Mosier had that in the park home run her last time at the plate. A repeat wouldn't be too bad. As that one does find the strike zone, the outside part of it. Two balls, one strike here. No outs, though. Gazelle's trying to go on a run of their own. As we saw Spearfish. As that one fouled straight back out of play. As we see the Pierre T.F. Riggs Governors are here warming up, getting ready for the later game today. In between this varsity game and the varsity game at 4 between Yankton and Pierre, there will be a JV game. We're going to do a video stream of that. I got some work to do. I won't be taking off for third. Churchma decides to take it on the throw back to the mound. A heads up play, as we saw that in the JV game as well. So now a runner on third. The count's full, 3-2, no outs. Mosier at the plate. Got a piece of that one high up into deep right field. That one's going back off the fence. It's not going to be a home run, but Mosier is heading for third. She's going to have a stand-up triple. She's got the two hardest parts of the cycle done already. A home run and a triple. If she gets a single and a double, she's got it. So now 9-7, Yankton hot at the plate. Three straight base hits for them. They have a, well, they have a single, a double, and a triple so far in this inning. Emma Herbel just needs to hit this one over, and they'll have the a team cycle all in a row. Now, Yankton with back-to-backs. They both just bounced off the fence. Neither were able to quite push it over. And you know that's going to be on their mind, thinking, man, if I could have just gotten that a touch, hit that one just a touch harder, would have been out of here. But Gazelles have a chance to bring it within one here. Emma Herbolt at the plate. Herbolt would be the game-tying run here in the bottom of the fourth. Sitzman, as Herbolt ropes that one into right center, as that one's going to one-hop the fence, as she's standing on second with a double, it's a one-run ball game, and the Gazelles' bats have come to life. So two doubles, a triple, a single here for the Gazelles. 9-8 is your new score. I mean, these two teams, all of a sudden, their batting has come to life. Already here in the fourth inning of play, that's only halfway over. We have nine combined hits from the two teams as we are going to see a substitution on the mound. Trying to get the number here. It will be Taylor Eady now on the mound. So she's going to take some time to warm up. We'll return in a moment. When we come back, it's Madison Girard at the plate for the Gazelles.
Your invitation to thrive in Yankton, South Dakota. Nestled on the bluffs of the Missouri River, plenty of outdoor adventures are waiting. Whether you work remote or in a traditional office, we have a spot for you. Quality health care, diverse manufacturing, progressive school system, Mount Marty University, and so much more. Explore with family and friends. Let's thrive together.
Again, a pitching change. It's Taylor Eady on the mound. Now we've seen both teams. So Madison Girard, she's 1-for-2 in the game. Gets a piece of that one right into right field. She's got a base hit. Herbolt, the tying run. She'll score. Girard's headed for third. She's standing with a triple. So we have everything besides a home run. Another triple here. Girard. Gazelles have a chance to take the lead after Herbolt ties things up. Madison Girard on third now with Tori Hansen. It will not be Tori Hansen. Excuse me, that is Eliza Gurney. She'll be batting in her first plate appearance. We saw her last night. She's 1-for-1 now on the season for her team. Hit a double. So it's Eliza Gurney batting in place of Tori Hansen. Hansen was 1-for-1, had a walk and a single. Eliza Gurney now, she gets a piece of that, fouls it. Counts 0-1. There's still no out, so Gazelles can take the lead here. Any base hit's going to score Girard from third. We'll see if Gurney also plays the field or if she's just batting in place of Hansen. As that's going to be a dead ball. She fouled it into herself. So 0-2 the count. All right, here we go, Taylor. Come on. We're all tied up 9-9 in the bottom of the fourth inning. Good try. Gurney, no swing on the off-speed pitch. One ball, two strikes here. Taylor Eady. Eliza Gurney up the middle. She's 2 for 2 for her career now on varsity. So Gurney scores Girard from third. Gazelles take the lead right back with 6 straight base hits here from them. 11 base hits for the Gazelles. And we're going to have another substitution. Jocelyn Burns batting. So 10-9, it's like this Gazelles batting has just totally flipped a few games into the season. Eady, as that one burns a soft one, that's going to land in the infield. An error, though, so Gurney's going to reach second. So Burns reaches off the error by the Spartans. Runners on first and second here. Haley Schulte at the plate. She's 1 for 2, hit a triple earlier. As Emma Iacker on deck. She's already had 3 at-bats in this game. She'll get her 4th as well. As that pitch low and away, ball 1. What a 4th inning of play for these two teams. 10 total runs scored so far in the 4th. That pitch also low. Scooped up, though, Liv Johnson doing a nice job keeping it in front of her. Prevents the runners from advancing any closer to home. Eady, that pitch, a hard hit grounder scooped up as the race to third. They'll get the lead runner. Nice play there by Skylar Wiesman, as that was a hard hit grounder from Schulte. Schulte on first with a fielder's choice. Over to second is Jocelyn Burns, and Gurney out at third. That's the first out here in the bottom of the 4th, Emma Iacker batting here. And on deck is Koletsky, who led off the inning as, well, again, Emma Iacker hit by a pitch. Base is now loaded. I mean, Iacker in her last 6 at-bats has been hit by a pitch 4 times. Talk about anyway on. Haley Schulte advances to second. Jocelyn Burns to third. Koletsky for the second time of the inning. She's 1 for 1 in the inning with a single. Takes the first pitch called for a strike. As I had mentioned, we do see her frequently take that first pitch, even if it looks good. As if you're a baseball fan, that was kind of Joe Mauer's method. Never swing at the first pitch. Koletsky hits that one hard, deep into right field. Base is loaded. It's one hopping, but Koletsky is going to clear the bases. Gazelle's looking to score 3. They do. Koletsky with a bases clearing double. As I'm sitting next to Corbin, I'm just waiting to shout out that one's out of here, that it's a home run. We've had a one hop to the fence. We've had 2 that just bounced directly off the fence. So Iacker all the way from first. It's Kyra Churchma at the plate. Iacker all the way from first ended up scoring. First pitch a strike. Jocelyn Burns from third easily made it. And Schulte from second able to make it. 13-9 is the score now. That pitch low and knocked towards the Gazelles dugout as Koletsky's trying to take 2 bases. She will. So no runners on, but Yankton scores again. 14-9. As Spearfish just trying to get out of this bottom of the 4th inning. Gazelles now have scored 9 runs in the bottom of the 4th. Koletsky alone has scored 2. She's hit a single and a double here in the bottom of the 4th. So Kyra Churchma now batting.
There you go, reset. We're good.
She has got a clean slate now. No runners on, 1 out here. As a grounder hit to second, picked up Throw gets there in time. Churchman will be out number two here in the bottom of the fourth. Play made there by Taylor Tennant. So now batting, Peyton Mosier. Well, Mosier can get nearer to the cycle. A single or a double puts her within one. That pitch, low, ball one. Middle of the day. Pretty much the perfect work day for myself. What a softball game. We've already seen 23 runs. Mosier, a hard hit to the outfield. She has another base hit here. She's going for two. Will she get the double? She just needs a single, and she's got the cycle. Mosier on second. She has come to life in this game. She's got the three hardest now of the cycle. She just needs a single, and she's got it. I don't think I've seen a single game in softball, in high school softball, where someone hit for the cycle. So Elena Nelson first pitch inside, gets past Elena Nelson in place of Mosier on second, takes off for third.
Go get it, Tay.
So Herbolt in this game, 2 for 3, 2 doubles, 1 strikeout. Takes a cut, doesn't get that one. 1-1 is the count. Has a runner on third in Nelson. Gazelles currently hanging on to a 14-9 lead now after they trailed 4 entering the inning. Swing and a miss from Herbolt there. Elena Nelson thought about taking off for home, decided against it. 1 ball, 2 strikes here. Next pitch. Herbolt is going to be called for strike three, as that will finally put the fourth inning of play to a close. But multiple batters, Koletsky, Churchma, Mosier, and Herbolt all getting 2 appearances at the plate in 1 inning. So Spearfish now trails 14-9. Leading off for them will be either, we'll see if it's Lainey O'Connell or Maya Hiding in a moment on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
TNRC Smith Insurance has been a part of the Yankton community since 1949. Our agency would love to help you with your home, auto, business, life, and long-term care insurance needs.
We take pride in providing you with quality service when you have a claim or need to make changes to your coverage.
The MT and RC Smith Insurance Agency is flexible to meet with you in person or at the office at 204 West 4th Street. Give them a call for insurance changes, payments, claims, or service requests.
14-9, Gazelles on top of the Spartans, leading off for Spearfish, as looks like a single-digit number. That would make it Maya Hiding. Maya Hiding is, in fact, batting again. She's 1 for 1 on the day, hit a single in the fourth inning there. Takes a cut, doesn't get it. On deck is Liv Johnson, the top of the lineup for Spearfish. As she gets a piece of that one, fouls it off out of play. 0-2 now the count. Hanson trying to get the first out here. That misses outside. 1 ball, 2 strikes. Top of the fifth inning here. Hiding trying to go 2 for 2 in the game, as a hard hit grounder over to second. Picked up. The throw makes it, as the out made by Jocelyn Burns standing on second. As Liv Johnson now at the plate. So Jocelyn Burns is playing the field and batting in place of McKenna Hatchiski. As that one's hit high up, as Mosier calling off Hansen, but she's going to drop it for an error, as standing on first is Liv Johnson. And that one is one the Gazelles really would like to have back. Being a catcher, those high hit balls are tough to catch. I know from experience, if anyone else was in the area, I always said, you can have it, because I had my fair share of those. Emmy Johnson now at the plate here for Spearfish. Got a piece of it, fouls it off. Liv Johnson will have to head back to first. So Hansen, 0-1 the count. As that one's hit up, could be into shallow right field, but Jocelyn Burns makes a heck of a play, an over-the-shoulder catch. Out number two, Danica Brown has one runner on for her. On deck is Kiana Staliker. So time is called here as Churchma lacing him up out at shortstop. Hansen fires. That one's fouled straight back. Brown got a piece of it. That's one that'll make you flinch. You know there's a net there, but sometimes just seeing it come straight at your face, doesn't matter what's in front of you. That one in for a strike on Danica Brown. She faces an 0-2 count here. As that one hit over on the left field side, out of play. The 0-2 pitch is low, ball one. Danica Brown still at the plate. It's Liv Johnson still on first. As that one misses inside a touch. 2-2. Danica in this one, 0-2. But she's reached twice off of a bean and a fielder's choice. As there she's got a base hit into left field. So Liv Johnson will stand on second. On first is Danica Brown with a single. That's the 11th base hit of the game for Spearfish. They trail five, so they're going to need a few runs here to close that gap. Kiana Staliker at the plate. Amy Rad-Couture on deck. Staliker, 1-for-3, hit a single. Also reached by error, as she'll have another base hit up the middle. Spearfish is going to head home. They're going to score one. So Liv Johnson gets home safely. Danica Brown will be standing on second. On first is Staliker with a single. Two base hits here in this inning for Spearfish. We have a combined 25 base hits in this game, and it's the top of the fifth inning here. That one scooped up by Churchma. Throw over to third. Heck of a play by Kyra Churchma at shortstop, and that's what we've come to expect from her. A very good fielder for the Gazelles, and Spearfish, though, does get one back. They trail four. It's 14-10. Gazelles lead when we return. Leading off will be Madison Girard.
Continually strive to improve the quality of service we provide the Yankton community. The Garden of Memories Cemetery and Winston Ray Funeral Home are pleased to announce the completion of a brand new columbarium. This columbarium is constructed of granite, designed to withstand the test of time. It is for those families choosing cremation and features above-ground outdoor niches, which includes a bronze plaque to memorialize your loved one, as well as indoor glass front niches where families can create a unique memorial with pictures or other family heirlooms. For more information, please give us a call at the Winston Ray Funeral Home in Yankton.
So leading off for the Gazelles will be Madison Girard. On deck, if she bats again, it'll be Eliza Gurney. Gurney, though, 2-for-2 to start. So won't be surprised if it is her hitting. First pitch to Girard. Girard gets a good piece of that one. Hard hit into left field. That's going to one-hop the fence. Girard's headed for second. She's going to be standing there. Another base hit by the Gazelles. They're batting out of nowhere. Just has absolutely exploded. 14 base hits in the game for Yankton. You know, you got to wonder. So Tori Hansen will bat again. As the throw down to third on the steal. Girard gets there safely. Pitch was called a ball, so 1-0 the count. Muth has been pretty aggressive with her base running for the Gazelles so far today, as we might have another challenge call out here on the field. The two officials and umpires, I should call them, are going to talk things over. So for the third time here, a challenged call. That'll be another Lindsay Echowater Systems of Yankton timeout, as that's a very quick one. They're going to call safe. You know, we're not really sitting at the best angle to see that. Whatever they call, I'm going to say is probably correct. So Tori Hansen batting. Gurney batted in her place last at bat, but Hansen, first pitch is low, ball two. On deck, looks like Jocelyn Burns. Hansen's got a piece of that one. It's going to be a dead ball, though, as bounced off her leg. Hansen, the 2-1 count, a line drive hit right at first off the glove, but they'll pick it up, get her out at first, as making it home safely is Girard. So that's the first out here in the bottom of the fifth. Jocelyn Burns at the plate. Schulte on deck. Jocelyn Burns sounded like she got a piece of it. Fouls it straight back into the glove, though, of Liv Johnson. As Jocelyn Burns 0-for-1, she did reach by error earlier. That pitch high. Burns made that great play out at second. As Burns, that's going to be hit to right field. She has a single, thinks about taking second. She's going to stay on first, though. So another runner here for the Gazelles. Haley Schulte at the plate. Her fourth at bat of the game. She's 1-for-3, hit a triple. Reached by fielder's choice and reached by error. So her on base, you know, she's made it on base all three of her at bats. Showing sign of bunt, she fouls that one off. Two base hits in the inning for the Gazelles. They have 15 now. That might be more hits than they've had combined. As Schulte pulls back the bunt. One ball, one strike, one out, one runner on. Gazelle's got that run back that Spearfish scored. Edie. Haley Schulte right up the middle. It's going to be off the glove and error as Schulte standing on first. Over to second is Jocelyn Burns. Emma Iacker batting for the fifth time of the game. Koletsky on deck. Churchma in the hole. First pitch is low in the ground, so both runners will take off, and they will advance. Jocelyn Burns is now on third with Schulte on second.
Go get it, Tank. Go get it.
Oh, 1-0 the count. Now that one's in for a strike. Iacker. As Iacker's hit again in 2 days, and she has another game to play today. In 2 days, she's been hit by a pitch five times now. I mean, you can't make this up. So she's on first now after the bean. I mean, is she just a ball magnet? Cameron Koletsky at the plate on deck. Kyra Churchma. Koletsky got a good piece of that right back at Muth. Having to show off her athletic ability jumping over that one. Wish we had that on video. I'd maybe have to save that clip to send over to her. But Koletsky with a double and a single in this game. Been kind of waiting for that breakout game for Koletsky. Got a good piece of that one as she fouls that one out of play. So the count 0-2. Taylor Eady facing the 0-2 count here. As that one gets by, runners advance and scoring from third is Jocelyn Burns. Schulte over to third. Iacker now on second. Score is now 16-10. Koletsky takes that one. It's inside. That one also gets to the backstop.
There we go. Reset.
It's now two balls, two strikes, one out. Runners on second and third here for the Gazelles. Koletsky at the plate, Churchma on deck, and Mosier in the hole. As Koletsky, a hard hit grounder, picked up at short. That will get over to first. Gazelles score one more run. Over to third is Iacker. So heading home was Schulte. Iacker now on third. Koletsky grounds out for the second out here of the bottom of the fifth. Churchma at the plate. On deck, Peyton Mosier has her shin guards on in case Churchma gets out. A grounder that gets through to left field. An RBI single here for Churchma. Scoring is Iacker. Another base hit here. And now kind of the moment I was waiting for. Peyton Mosier is batting. If she hits a single here, she has officially hit for the cycle in this game. Takes first pitch. It's a strike. 0-1 the count. 18-10 Gazelles lead. As she hits that one, it's deep into right field. She's not taking the single, though. She's going to head for two. She's headed for three. She wants another triple. She's got it. They say the triple's the hardest part of a cycle. She's done it twice. She just doesn't have the single. So Mosier, another triple. That scores Churchma from first. Emma Herbold at the plate. With the score now 19-10, if Emma Herbold scores her runner, that would be game, and Elena Nelson will be running in place of Mosier at third, Herbold at the plate. Herbold 2-for-4 in the game. Yeah, the umpire, hang with me, ladies. Making sure he's got everything. As Herbolt, a dribbler to first. She's going to get tagged out. So that is the, they're going to say save. As, you know, that one I might have to say I thought she tagged her. So I guess Herbolt was safe on first. Not sure if the tag missed, but that will make it a victory for the Yankton Gazelles. They 10-run them as Elena Nelson makes it home in place of Mosier. As 20-10 is your final score, with the Gazelles coming away with a second straight victory. And as I talked with Coach Muth, that's what you needed to get rolling. You need that first win. They've added on a second one within less than 24 hours. They have two wins here. Again, 20-10 as the Gazelles bats were on fire. Muth is going to be happy to talk. Now, she usually kind of picks, after a Gazelles win, she picks one of the athletes to come chat with us. I usually don't know. I got a feeling I know who it's going to be today. There's only one player who hit a home run, two triples, and a double in the game. And I think she's probably going to be headed this way. We'll be back in a moment, though, to chat with Jill Muth and, of course, the Gazelle of the Day in a moment on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Know what to do. Ever since my neighbor grew in, he just keeps pushing.
Move over! Y'all in my way! Hey, where do you keep the snacks around here? Hey, put me down!
So long, loudmouth.
Two is company, but three's a crowd.
Wisdom teeth mouthing off? Sounds like a job for Siouxland Oral Surgery. We're the oral surgery specialists with the tools and training to deliver better diagnoses, greater safety, and better outcomes.
There's a whole new world out there. It's called the off-road, and it's waiting to be explored in a Polaris. So gear up to make every moment count with the Polaris off-road vehicle. The new Polaris 2024 models are in at Stockman's Motorsports in Yankton. Get ready to tackle the trails this winter. With machines like these, your world just gets bigger. Stop in at Stockman's Motorsports today to learn more about the epic new Polaris off-road lineup.
AR's Oasis in Yankton, your one-stop store for everything you need. The parking lot, it's the biggest in town for ease of getting in and out. Oh, and the selection they have inside, it's unbeatable. Energy drinks, coffee, pop, and even something for the adults. Now the food selection, they only give me 30 seconds, but there's daily specials posted right on the outside, along with burgers, ribs, and so much more. JR's Oasis, Highway 50 East, Yankton.
Piper, the sign says it all. Flowers and gifts. The store is bustling with something new all the time. There are flowers for any occasion, weddings, anniversary, birthday, or just to say I love you. There's coffee, soups, dips, and sweets. Need to give someone a chuckle? The socks say it all. Home decor, candles, jewelry, memorial items are all found at your gift store of Pied Piper Flowers and Gifts, corner of 15th and Broadway in Yankton. You can also shop online, and best of all, we deliver too.
From sunup to sundown, the work ethic of the farmer is unquestioned. As farming methods change and evolve, you need a financial partner to help you reach your goals. Elkhorn Valley Bank's experienced lenders are committed to providing dependable advice and fast local decisions, no matter the size of the operation. From farmland to livestock, you can count on us today and in the future. Elkhorn Valley Bank and Trust. There really is a difference.
And back at Sertoma Park, another Gazelles victory and another smile on head coach Jill Muth's face as she's here to chat with me. Muth, according to my stats, 20 runs off of 17 hits. I'm not going to say it's 100% correct. It's close at least, so
yep.
Your bats yep. absolutely came to life in today's game.
Absolutely. That's what I told him in the huddle after the game. I said, I don't know who woke the bats up, but thank you. It was about time. The first couple innings we had a few hits here and there, and I think it was that fourth inning where we just ended up scoring
9 runs there.
9 runs, and just it was like a hit parade, you know. I think Kyra started us off, or Cam. Cam, I think, started us off that inning.
Yep, it was, I believe, I went all the way through, so I had to go into the next inning for my scorekeeping.
So Cam started us off, and then it was like double and double. Kyra barely missed one off the fence. Moj, I think, missed two off the fence, but, you know, that means we're hitting line drives, okay? I'd love to see line drives. If a line drive gets out, great, but we want to hit the ball hard, and that's what we accomplished today. So that was nice to see that happen. And Madison pitched a couple good innings for us, and Tori came in and had one, you know, a little bit rough inning, but she battled back, and after we scored all those runs, she came out and threw strikes, and that's what we're asking her to do, is just throw strikes, and hopefully we can make plays behind her.
And I love that you mentioned there was about two or three that either one-hopped or bounced right off the fence. Jill, as an announcer, I was so excited, I got to say, it's going back, oh, and just couldn't quite.
I think there were a couple girls out there wearing red that were thinking the same thing, too. They were hoping that they were over the fence, but it's all right. I'd rather us hit it hard than have a pop fly that just gets blown out. So we're happy with line drives, too, aren't we?
Absolutely. That was, you know, great hitting performance, great performance overall. 20 runs is going to win you a lot of games here. And, you know, you had a few players really come to life here. Cameron Koletsky had a good day at the plate. Peyton Mosier, who we're waiting to chat with here in a moment, a fantastic game.
Yeah, and just 4 for 5 with a double, a triple, and a home run. Doggone it, Moj.
Two triples, might I add,
oh,
too.
We should have stopped you at first. Got you the cycle.
And that's, I was going to maybe say, don't say anything. I was going to ask her, if she was aware of that, but but nearly the cycle, a fantastic game, Jill. And now you've got another one to look forward to.
Yep, we got another opportunity to go get 2 more wins here. That was our goal today, see if we could get 4 wins. We're 2 for 2 so far, so got some work to do. But hoping we can keep our momentum rolling and go get a couple more.
All right, thanks so much, Coach. We'll chat with you before the Pier game. And now Peyton Mosier for the first time here. Just a fantastic game overall. Congrats on the win.
Thank you.
And I was going to ask you, were you aware that if you just needed that single for the cycle, were you aware of that?
No, I wasn't, so that's kind of crazy to think about. But, yeah, bat came alive today, which is good.
Yes, it did. And so, of course, he hit it. It was to right center, and I was kind of wondering, is she going to stand on first and get that cycle? And you just tore off for a second. I was like, okay, she's got a double. Next thing you know, you're headed for third. Another triple. I mean, you did the hardest part of the cycle twice.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then an in-the-park home run, a fantastic performance. But, you know, the bats for you and your team overall, really, they just – It came to life. It was like everyone decided, all right, this is the game we're going to come out, and we're just going to play well. And I'm sure you guys are enjoying the beautiful weather.
Yeah, it's nice to have at least one day without minimal wind here. So it's good to get that in.
Isn't that the truth? South Dakota, I mean, what was it last night? I think we had gusts of up to 40, 45
yeah,
miles per hour.
Yeah.
So. But I got one final question for you. It has nothing to do with softball. So I work at a radio station.
Yep.
I've got to ask, Mosier, is there a favorite band or artist that you love listening to?
Yes, I'm a big country girl.
Country.
Yes, Zach Bryan is probably my top tier answer there. I'm a big Zach Bryan fan.
Big Zach Bryan fan,
yes. Yet.
Well, I might not know his music, but he's got a good first name, so I'm sure he's great.
Yep.
All right. Yeah. Well, thank you so much, Mosier, for the chat. I appreciate it. Fantastic game, and good luck in the next one.
Thank you so much.
Again, that was head coach Jill Muth, followed by Peyton Mosier, who just had an outstanding game today. And lots of smiles from the Gazelle sideline. I do want to note, so there's another game today between Yankton and Pier. We're actually going to have a video stream. I'm not going to be doing play-by-play. I've got some work to do. But for the JV, I will keep a stream running. You'll be able to watch it. And, you know, something we haven't done in the past, I'm going to be at least near the field for the rest of the day, so I figured, why not? Let's have a video stream of the JV girls. Lots of talented athletes who maybe don't always get the media coverage that they really could. So we're going to have, again, between Pier and Yankton, we're going to have it's going to be a video only. So debating between having the audio on so you can hear the crowd, what's going on. I'll probably do that, have a microphone on so you can kind of hear what's going on. There will be no play-by-play until the varsity game. Again, I've got some work to do. Not that this isn't my work, but other stuff I got to get done. But a great day at Sertoma Park. Softball, I mean, a great, beautiful day. Glad to be out here. I'm Zach Spear alongside Corbin Gunther on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube. And in just a moment, we'll go live with the JV game between Pier and the Yankton Gazelles. Until then, have a great day, and hopefully see you for the next game.